both together. Yeah. Because when you're being realistic, and this can tell you, I was, this is something that we had been. There are people that are never going back, including my parents. They've just bought a house somewhere else. So, and there are people that are just so, they have just like a wounded their nervous system, because it's been going on for like 4 years. First we had these earthquakes, before we had the first eruptions, and now in 3 years almost we had 5 eruptions, and these two really, really close to the town. So one question we are asking as well, when, where will it erupt again?
After a quiet period of around 800 years, we are now witnessing again volcanic activity on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And this is something that we have to live with, and that we will do. We did our very best to defend the town itself. We built defensive structures, and always uppermost in our minds is to protect people's lives, and we will continue to do so.
The most risk is still in the town of Grindavík, and the town of Grindavík has one of the most important fishing harbors in Iceland, so it is obviously very bad for the society when it is not fully functioning. And we have been worried about Svartsengi, the geothermal power plant, and the Blue Lagoon. But they are located close to the eruption area. But again, we must remember that the reason for our green geothermal energy, amazing tourist attraction, and the well-being in Iceland is because of the power from the volcano nature. So sometimes it is good and benefit for the people, but sometimes it's threatening us.
What we have done in near Grindavík and in the area called Svartsengi, where we have one of the big power plants, we have built barriers 6 to 8 to 10 meters high that is supposed to divert the lava if it will come in that area. It's supposed to divert the lava away from the power plant. And we have already had experience in this because on the eruption that we had 14th of January, the barriers that we are building around the town of Grindavík diverted the lava away from the town. So most of the lava was not affecting the town at all, but we have some part of the fissure opening within the barriers. So some of the lava there went into the town and took out 3 houses. But most of it, and the main thing that we saw is that the barriers are working. So we know, now we know more about how to build them and how to use them.
Of the water, and you can feel it on the skin because we're using the water.